farms in their nest. Workers deliver the leaf pieces to other ants working on fungus farms. Those who take in the leaves first clean them. Then they chop them into bits. Now it's the turn of the smallest ants. These ants are 2 millimeters in length, which is about the size of a grain of sand. They chew these bits into pulp and apply this pulp over the ground of the fungus farming field. Then they ferment fungus on this pulp. Oh, look at that! The green color of the leaves has disappeared in a single day. The following day, white layers of growing fungus lay over the pulp of the leaves. And the foods that ants can eat has finally been produced. Now they can harvest the fungus. These fungus-harvesting ants first care for the other ants and carry the fungus they have collected to workers. Here is an ant that collected fungus. It offers the nourishing fluid obtained from the fungus to a worker working at a different place of the nest. In this way, all ants, from the leaf-cutting ones to the chewing ones, are provided with the food they need. Once all the fungi are collected, the leftovers remain, which need to be removed. Workers carry each bit one by one and clean the production chamber. There are other ants performing other tasks in the colony. For example, defense of the nest is undertaken by strong, brave, and self-sacrificing soldier ants. Have you heard it too? Who can it be? Soldier ants must have heard that sound. I wonder what they will do. You may find it difficult to believe that soldier ants would even bite shoes and socks of a man approaching their nest. Once they seize something with their claws, they never set it free. Even if the rest of their bodies are injured, they do not retract their claws, but sacrifice their own lives in defense of the colony. This is quite a serious sacrifice. Ants establish a perfect order, but still, there is neither a division of labor nor an ant supervising the operation in the colony. However, each ant miraculously knows which task it should carry out. Division of labor has been done before they were born, and ants perform their service perfectly. It is God, creator of all things, who makes ants perform all these tasks. This fact is related in the Quran as follows. Everyone in the heavens and the earth belongs to Him. All are submissive to Him. Did you know? This pretty creature sleeping peacefully on a branch of the eucalyptus tree is a koala, which is an Australian animal. The reason why koalas make their homes in these trees is that they feed on their leaves. These leaves contain distinctive chemicals. These chemicals are poisonous to all animals except koalas. But since God created koalas that cannot be harmed by this plant, this koala lives a happy life among the eucalyptus leaves. The camel is an animal that has been a symbol of the endless deserts. The most important need of a camel in the arid heat of the desert is water. But it is very hard to find water in a desert. Therefore, camels store it whenever they find a source of water. A camel can consume up to 130 liters of water at once. In addition, it is almost impossible to find food in the endless sands. God created a special food storage in the camel's body so that it can resist hunger. This storage is the hump on its back. Approximately 40 kilograms of fat are stored in the hump. Thanks to this storage, a camel can survive for days without eating any food. These perfect systems in the camel's body are among the infinite proofs of the unbounded knowledge and wisdom of God. God encourages us to reflect on this fact and commands in the Quran as follows. Haven't they looked at the camel? How it was created? The morality God demands from us. Loving God and giving thanks to Him. We know that we, and all other living beings, are created by God.